So now let's take a look at the evolution of IAEA safeguards. The safeguard system has not remained constant throughout the history of the IAEA. It's actually gone through three major phases of IAEA safeguards that have occurred. And the first one begins with the creation of the IAEA in the 1950s and 60s, as nations were just beginning to trade in nuclear technology and supply nuclear facilities to other nations and trade nuclear fuel. They're just learning how this would occur. The IAEA safeguard system is established to ensure that this did not lead to the spread of nuclear weapons. And this is encoded in INFCIRC 66, which spelled out refers to Information Circular, which is an approved document from either the UN or the IAEA, also distributes information circulars. And INFCIRC 66 was the initial set of safeguards that the IAEA would use to safeguard the international nuclear industry. And then in 1968 to about 1991, that begins with when the NPT was signed, the Non-Proliferation Treaty. The IAEA was legally tasked to apply safeguards on all nuclear materials in non-nuclear weapon states that were party to the NPT. So this expanded the role of IAEA safeguards. Before, with just INFCIRC 66, the IAEA safeguards were applied only where they were agreed to between different states and the IAEA, whether that was required by a supplier state or not. There are several scenarios when they could have been applied. But beginning in 1968, when the NPT was negotiated, all non-nuclear weapon member states of the NPT were required to have IAEA safeguards on any nuclear material within their borders. And this is referred to as INFCIRC 153, Information Circular 153. And then in 1991, there was another revision to the safeguard system. This came about due to the clandestine nuclear weapons program in Iraq and also some of the problems in applying safeguards in North Korea. And also the experience gained in verifying the denuclearization of South Africa. And this is embodied in Information Circular 540, INFCIRC 540. And this codifies what's known as the additional protocols, which gives the IAEA basically more access and better access to facilities within the state. And it also emphasizes the IAEA safeguards in preventing clandestine programs and verifying that there is not proliferation activity elsewhere in a state besides within its nuclear facilities.